Hi, my dear students. In this lecture, we are going to revise together our chapter 2, which is about greatest common factor, the GCF, and the least common multiple, the LCM, of two or more numbers. If you still remember, last year we studied how we find the GCF and the LCM of two natural numbers. In this lesson, we are going to find it for two or more natural numbers. So the objective of our lesson is to find the GCF and the LCM of two or more natural numbers. Here we are going to use the method which is the prime factorization method. The method of prime factorization says that every composite natural number can be decomposed into prime factors or prime numbers. If you still also remember, the prime factors or the prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, etc. These are the prime numbers. So to decompose a natural number into prime factors, we try to divide this number starting from number 2. If we can divide it, we get the answer. If we cannot divide it by 2, we try by 3 and so on. Here we should apply the criteria of divisibility of numbers. When does our prime factorization finish? It finishes when the answer of division is 1. The criteria of divisibility: a number is divisible by 2 if the ones of this number is even, by 3 if the sum of digits is a multiple of 3, by 4 if the ones and tens are a multiple of 4, by 5 if the ones is 0 or 5, by 6 if it's divisible by 2 and 3, by 9 if the sum of digits is a multiple of 9, by 10 if the ones is 0. So now, using the prime factorization method, we should decompose these numbers into product of prime factors. Let's do together number 72. This is number 72 and we draw a vertical line. Can we divide 72 by 2? Yes, because the ones is even. So if we divide it using the method of division by 2, it will give us the answer, which is 36. 36 can only be divided, can also be divided by 2. It gives us 18. 18 can be divided by 2. It gives us 9. Now 9 cannot be divided by 2. So we try by 3. 9 divided by 3 is 3, and 3 divided by 3 is 1. So if we want to write 72 as a product of prime factors, it is 2 cubed times 3 squared. And always we put our answer inside a box. To find the greatest common divisor of 3 numbers, or the greatest common factor, using the method of prime factorization, we find D1. What's D1? It's the GCD of the first two numbers. Then we find D, which is the GCD of 2, 1 and the third number. So to find the GCD, as we said, we choose the common prime factors with the least exponents. For example, if I gave you these three numbers, 360, 200 and 756, we should find the GCD of these three numbers. So 360, we make its prime factorization. We get 360 is equal to 2 cubed times 3 squared times 5. And we also make the prime factorization of 200. We get 200 equal 2 cubed times 5 squared. Now we get the GCD of these two numbers, which is D1. In GCD, we choose the common with the least exponent. So between 2 cubed and 2 cubed, we take 2 cubed. Between 5 and 5 squared, we take 5. 3 is not common, so we do not take the factor 3. Now here we found the GCD of the first two numbers. Now we make the prime factorization of the third number. We get these are the prime factorization of the third number. Now to find the GCD of the three numbers together, we find it the common between D1 and the prime factors of the third number. It is only 2 squared. So the GCD of these three numbers is 2 squared. The least common multiple of two numbers, the LCM. Also, we should find the least common multiple. Here we should have the LCM. The least common multiple using the method of prime factorization. We find M1, which is the LCM of the first two numbers. Then we find M, the LCM of M and the third number. To find the LCM, what do we choose from the prime factorization? We choose the common prime factors with the greatest exponents, and we also take the non-common factors. For example, if I gave you these three numbers, 144, 600, and 1260, we should find its prime factorization. To find the prime factorization, we make the prime factors of 144. These are the prime factors. These are the prime factors of 600. Now we find their GCD. This is the GCD of the LCM of the first two. Now we make the prime factorization of the third number, and we take the common between this number and the LCM of the first two. We get the LCM of the three numbers together. There is an important relation between the GCD or the GCF and the LCM of two natural numbers. If we have two numbers A and B, then their GCD is D, small is their GCD, and M is their LCM. Then we can write the GCD of these two numbers times the LCM of these two numbers is equal to the product of the two numbers together. If two numbers are relatively prime, this means their GCD is 1. How can we find the LCM? The LCM is the product of these two numbers given to us.